What's happening, guys? Keith here with your August 1st edition of the Impact Report. So on the latest edition of the Impact Report, I spoke about Conan sending out a challenge to the Young Bucks. Well, they accepted and Chris Jericho made it official. We are getting the Young Bucks versus LAX on the Chris Jericho Cruise. This is the second announced Ring of Honor versus Impact Wrestling match, the first being Sami Callihan versus Marty Scurll. Both should be fantastic matches. Hopefully we get some video of them in the future. It was also announced, this one being on Monday, that Impact Wrestling has signed Rich Swann long-term. This was announced through their Twitter page. I know Rich Swann was hesitant signing, just wasn't sure if it was the right fit yet, but apparently it is because he has signed the deal. Fantastic news for Impact Wrestling and Rich Swann. So, Abyss was recently interviewed by WrestleZone, and this coming after him signing a new contract. He was asked whether his new Impact Wrestling contract is a wrestling contract or a producer contract. He said, "It's going to be both. I will continue my roles as an agent, a producer, and a talent as well. You'll see some Abyss and maybe his esteemed brother Joseph Park. But my duties will also be heavily involved backstage, agenting, producing, and helping the young talent out. I am really excited about that." He was asked about his strengths as a producer backstage. He says, "I think that I am probably a little more of an agent when it comes to the wrestling side of things. The promo side of stuff has been split up. Jimmy Jacobs handles a lot of the promo stuff, and he is so strong at it. He handles a lot of that, and I handle a lot of the action. I focus on the matches and a lot of the in-ring or backstage segments that have physicality. I focus more on that on the wrestling side of things." He is asked also about feeling a new wave of momentum behind Impact Wrestling following their stellar Slammiversary pay-per-view. He says, "It feels great. I have been here through it all since the beginning, and it's been a long time since we've had that kind of buzz that Slammiversary produced for us. The roster went out there and just tore it down. The whole thing, top to bottom, was just great. Pentagon vs. Sami Callihan, LAX and the OGs, Austin vs. Moose. Top to bottom, they just left it all in the ring. You can see that everyone is just physically and mentally exhausted. I've been here a long time, and we haven't had that kind of buzz coming out of a pay-per-view in a long, long time. It's exciting stuff. It's positive, and we really think that we can follow it up going into the fall and onto Bound for Glory in October. We are really excited. It's no secret that the company has taken its licks over the years, and to have something positive come out now, to have the people that didn't traditionally give us credit or positive feedback, they are giving us positive feedback now. It's something to really build off of now, and we definitely don't want to rest on it. We want to produce quality television and keep it strong." He was also asked on working more intimate venues for Impact Wrestling TV and pay-per-views. He says, "For years, Orlando was a great home for us. It really was. Universal Studios was a great home, but like anything, I don't care what you are producing. If you do it in the same building long enough, no matter what you do, it's going to become a challenge. It definitely became a challenge for us to put on our TV where we were getting the positive, great feedback. The crowd was just kind of burnt out. To move it around now, smartly, to move it around to venues like we had in Toronto for Slammiversary, that was a small, intimate venue, but boy, it was packed. You can feel the atmosphere just coming through your television screen as you watched it. It's not a terribly large venue, but it's a beautiful venue. That's what we are focused on, and that's what you are going to see over the next year. We will be doing TV in some different places. We've already announced New York for Bound for Glory in October. We'll definitely be moving around the country and keeping it fresh. The presentation is so important when you watch the show and you are seeing people sitting on their hands during one of the hottest stories you're telling. It just doesn't come across your TV and translate. That's one thing we are really doing well and fixing is just going to different venues and trying to keep it fresh. Fresh crowds, fresh reactions, and I think it definitely translates through the TV screen. If you watch something that the people on TV are excited about, I think it translates through your screen and enhances the viewer's pleasure. I and the company are excited about that." So, good stuff from Abyss there. Definitely agree about the Orlando stuff and the crowd being hyped. Definitely keeps it more interesting as you're watching. So on the latest edition of the Killing the Town podcast, Don Callis was talking with Paul Lazenby about the controversy surrounding the Scarlett Bordeaux character. Here's some highlights that 411 Mania was nice enough to post. They talked about the controversy around Scarlett character. And Don said, "See now, I did not see that because I was following her name on Twitter during the show and it was like 90% positive. The worst thing I saw, someone wrote an article and said, well, they've got to be very careful about how they're doing this. The good thing was the person was smart enough to understand that what Scarlett is doing is basically saying, hey, I am not going to be told how to dress and how to look and that I shouldn't look how God made me. And I'm not going to cover up because some man or whatever thinks it's politically correct for me to cover up. If I want to dress like this, I'm going to dress like this. This is me. And I thought that was an empowering message from her. But some people, you know, they look for the things to be offended about and whatever. I'm unclear as to what anything she said was offensive. Also, let's all understand this is a wrestling show. Did you get mad at the lead heel in the last movie you saw and want to go and send the actors letters because he didn't like the character? Everyone's playing a role here, so let's just be clear. But I thought it was interesting what she did, and I think that people will be pleasantly surprised as we move forward. She's actually a very good wrestler, and I think it got people talking in a good way. And yeah, I think people are going, oh, what are they going to do now? And I don't know what they think is going to happen here, but you never know. You're going to have to tune into Impact on Pop TV in the USA every Thursday night at 8 o'clock or on the Game TV and the Fabulous Fight Network in Canada to check it out. It is must-see programming, especially the most recent tapings from Toronto in the Rebel Entertainment Complex. What a great venue. I think our male demographic will go up with Scarlett. I'm not sure." And then he was asked if this was a shot at the WWE. He says, "You know, this is true, and I don't mean this as a knock because I don't watch anything. It's funny. I used to laugh when I would hear Eric Bischoff talk about back in the WCW days that he didn't watch ECW. Like, I never watched that. I was like, oh, BS, he didn't watch it. No, I now believe that Eric Bischoff did not watch ECW or much of anything else because he wouldn't have any goddamn time to do it, and I totally understand that. So I legitimately haven't watched WWE in many, many, many years, and it's not because I don't want to or because it's not great. I mean, I'm a subscriber to the network and all of that, but, you know, you just don't have the time. I don't watch other promotions either. So, yeah, I don't know what they're doing on that. This was an independent kind of thing with Scarlett, and I think she's going to be a star, and she's going to do a great job with it. And I think if you've learned nothing else from watching Impact the last 6 or 7 months, I think you should know that if you think you know what's going to happen, you probably don't, and that's probably how entertainment should be." Well said, Don. So, last, they have announced that there is another one-night-only special in August, and it takes place at the same night as the Night of the Dummies, which will be in production with Excite Wrestling in Binghamton, New York on August 25th. The second one announced is taking part with Destiny Wrestling, happening also on Saturday, August 25th, in Canada. This one is going to be called Bad Intentions. Right now, the only match they have announced, I believe, is Sami Callihan versus Josh Alexander in a cage. On the poster is Sami Callihan, OVE, Josh Alexander, Petey Williams, Tessa Blanchard, and Michael Elgin. So, kind of cool. They're doing one for the USA and one for Canada. That was confirmed by Destiny Wrestling, so good stuff there. I wonder if this will be, or when this will be updated on the GWN. Not sure about that, but cool stuff there. That's really all I have for you guys this week. I will see you guys Friday for my review. And until then, thanks for checking out my video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.